Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Frame nine. Luca Brasil.
A very good morning, Seema, and good morning, everyone. Once again, terrific reception for all four players. And I had the pleasure of doing this match yesterday, the first session. It was very, very entertaining and great to be sitting next to Joe Perry.
Morning, Dennis. Yeah, always good to watch Mark Williams in action. Fantastic player. And I watched quite a bit of that session yesterday and I was very impressed with Luca. Yeah, it was hard to split them yesterday, wasn't it? Looked like Mark was off to a flyer, but Luca settled in and he played some amazing shots. He's a bit of a shot maker.
Yeah, from 2-0 down, he knocked in a century break. But of course, Mark Williams came back in the next frame with his century. And straight away in this opening frame of this morning session, the reds are nicely spread around the table there. Always a little annoying when you catch a ball colour with a safety. This would be a nice one to knock in to start your day.
One.
A solid long pot. Always had safety Bramble. In mind. That's why he's not on a ball colour, but chance to get the early initiative here.
Luca Brasil one.
Pretty decent. Might not be straightforward for Mark to not leave a pot on here for Luca. Reds are nicely spread. Nothing staring out of the red to sort of lay up close to. One on the side cushion, but that leaves a couple of pots for Luca, so early little problem here for Mark Williams.
Yeah, you'll have to give this a little bit of thought. Because you say the only red near a cushion is the one near his hand there. And if he does land on that, he's going to leave the one that's just above the black for the right corner. So you'll have to give this a little bit of thought. He'll do well to get out of this situation without leaving something on. He was looking at the possibility of landing on the red just to the left of the bunch. Yeah, the one he did look at was the one on the circle. He was thinking if I land on that one, will everything be safe? But that's not straightforward.
Yeah, just looking now, the two reds just to the right of the pink as we look. You could get in there, that's pretty safe, but not easy to get there. I think the brown's in the way for the natural route. May have to go twice across the table. But yeah, this is really tough. And for Mark Williams to be taking this long over a shot tells you just how difficult it is. One of the quickest thinkers in the game.
Yeah, sometimes you stood at the table and you just cannot see a shot to play. Doesn't happen very often, but this is definitely one of those cases. Yeah, it was very, very difficult to find a position that he wasn't leaving a pot on. So the one to the left, it's just about the little cannon here. I don't think he can screw through the gap. There is a little gap if he pots this one that he might squeeze through or just glance off one of them and he'll be on the blue or the brown.
One. Oh,
it's gone a bit awkward. But he has the brown. And there is a red for the left corner.
Five.
Yeah, pretty straight, this red. So we've got a choice here. We're looking to just squeeze the pocket a little bit and run round off two cushions. Oh, he's played it dead weight.
Six.
Just about wriggled in. Wasn't in the middle of the pocket, but because of the speed, he hit it. Gave the pocket every chance, but again, just can't quite get that cue ball under control just yet in this little break. Straight on the black now, so gonna have to leave himself a tough red to the middle or one of the top corner pockets.
That was all he could do with the
13
hampered bridge hand. Well, that was quite ambitious.
Luca Brazel.
That was a tough 30. One he took on there. And he's left a chance for Mark Williams here. Oh, that was tough.
One. Eight. Nine.
Just come up a little bit short, but not a problem heading up for the blue.
Again, just a little bit short, but ideal. Taking this one all around the table, just going to leave himself mid-distance, but decided to go around the back of the ball colours and hasn't achieved that. So good pot needed now.
28.
Keep this going. He can play this red with an element of safety if he wishes, but pot either red here, the one in the middle of the table, stun across for the black in the same pocket. Red down the cushion, neither of them are easy.
Well,
29.
Wow, this is awesome. And you know where he got his nickname, the Welsh potting machine, from when you see shots like that.
36.
It's amazing, Joe.
37.
How many of the top players and the best potters in the game are all left-handers. It's quite incredible. Neil Robertson. You've got Jimmy White, Judd Trump, Mark Allen. There's so many of them.
Yeah, and when I think back when I first 45. Started watching snooker, there weren't that many really. Just Jimmy White, Tony Meo. There seems to be just as many left-handers as right-handers these days. But you're right, they do seem to have that little bit of extra natural flair for potting good balls.
45.
But Mark Williams going about this nicely. A little cannon needed now, you would expect, if he gets the meet in his pack, pink and the two reds together. He's going to be on something. Well, mind you, there's a red at the bottom here available. So. Yeah, well, that was the trouble. It was hard to hold for that red, and he's not ideal now. That's why I thought he might have played a little cannon. Couldn't see 50. How that would go wrong.
It's not too reds in. I mean, that, the one he tried to pot was a thin cut, but then he's produced two in the same pocket. Quite unusual to see them go in like that. The difference. So he
57.
Only needs this red to leave Luca requiring a snooker, but he's got an angle on this so he can get out on green or brown.
58.
Always nice to start off an early morning session like this. Frame safe, potential century, but it's going to be difficult with the yellow safe and that red near the middle pocket, not ideally placed. Doesn't really matter
Williams,
about missing
62.
That, but he's annoyed. You don't often see that. He's really annoyed with himself there. Very rare sight that.
1.
Yeah, but we see it a lot, don't we, Dennis? You know, the frame you would imagine is safe, but two snookers required. If Mark knocks that red in, Luca doesn't come back to the table and we get on with the next one and you can build some momentum.
8.
Well, that's what it means to Mark Williams. Doesn't often give much away.
Luca Brazil. 8.
But there's the first of the snookers that Joe talked about, and that's why Mark was annoyed. He didn't want to be involved in this. He wanted to be getting on with the second frame. I think he can come off the one cushion here. Well, that angle he's looking at, he'd have to have a terrific amount of side on the ball. Do you know, I think the brown might be slightly in the way of coming off the one cushion. but that's where he wants. But he'll have to play it with lots of left-hand side.
Yeah, it's two snookers, two four-point penalty snookers. But if he hits the blue or pink, that changes things. Well, he didn't quite get enough side on, did he? So that's one snooker.
Look at Brassell.
Now we see exactly why Mark Williams was frustrated when he missed that red.
Maybe a snooker, but I think he can bend this around the pink. Because there's no escape off either side cushion, so is he thinking of going in behind the yellow off two cushions? I think I'd prefer the swerve shot, which he's decided on. Oh, what a great picture that is. You've got the perfect picture of a swerve shot there.
Yeah, it was a good escape in the end, wasn't it? I didn't realise it was such a big swerve. And it could have saved him in this frame, because that's a poor one from Luca. So, chance now. Mark Williams finally wrap this frame up.
One.
He come walking up the table. I was just looking at him. He was mumbling away to himself, still probably annoyed at killing the frame off previously. But it's great to see that. It just shows what it means to
eat
a seasoned campaigner like this. He knows he's got a tough match on his hands.
Eight and the frame.
So he'll be delighted with this start. It was that area break of 62 that paved the way to give the Welshman the frame. And he gets his nose in front. It's 5-4.
Frame 10, Mark Williams.
Seen Mark Williams do this over the last few seasons. He obviously is not comfortable hiding that cue ball off the break off, so rather than give Luca any glimpse at a long red, he plays that shot. This is the one big difference about Mark Williams. He can mix it up, can play so many different ways. Just makes your opponent think, doesn't it, Dennis? She's just not expecting it. You expect to come to the table in bulk.
Yeah, in fact, Luca left him a tempter into the middle pocket, which he almost converted, but he's so close to the... Watch it again. It comes back into a potable position.
One.
So this time, maybe the break-off shot working against him, especially if he catches the pink full on. He's got to be careful. There's a red he may plant into the left corner, but he hasn't looked at it. Oh, it wasn't far away. But it didn't get it full on the cannon.
Six.
When you hit the pink half ball, always a chance of going in off to either corner. This is a tough one next to the black here.
Oh, sorry. Seven.
Very good pots there from Luca. Get himself back in position. The red wasn't easy. Or the black.
$50.
Now a little bit low on this black again. So may have to play another little cannon here. Just if he can avoid hitting the pink first when he pots the black, should be okay. He might just brush off the bunch and cross to the left hand side of the table for that open red there. Oh, he's hit that very hard and he's lost the cue ball. Gonna need a little bit of luck now. Surprised he hit it that hard.
22.
Yeah, I'm also surprised. I mean, it was a correct shot, but just seemed to put an awful lot of pace into it, and this is very missable. This is a tricky shot. Well played.
23.
Oh, excellent. You won't see a better recovery shot than that.
Yeah, that's why he's good fun to watch, isn't he, Luca? Doesn't always play conventional 30. Shots. I'm sending frame one of this session. He's a shot maker. And we saw one there. Great imagination 30. And creativity in his break building. So if he can't, he'd like to just screw out past the bunch for the red in the left corner, but too much angle on the black here, so similar sort of shot, unless you can just avoid the pink again. Well, he could, but he hasn't put enough pace on it. He wanted to be on this red into the middle. It's okay if it goes past the blue.
38.
Oh, is he looking at the one at the bottom of the pack? Oh, this again. This will open everything up.
$39.
A little bit unfortunate there if he's not on the black. Pink is there, but again, going to need a good pot here, and the cue ball's running away.
Just wondering if he can use that red to the left as a stopper for the cue ball. Well, he couldn't cannon that, so he's had to drop it in dead weight. And now it's a Belgian 45. Bullet that looks totally relaxed out there. This is a great response to that opening frame.
Look at Brussel, 45.
And all of a sudden, he puts one of those in. Nobody's seen that coming. He'd done all the hard work, opened everything up.
One.
He was just stretching. Well, that red was a little bit of a distraction under his arm there, and he didn't push the cue through in a straight line after doing all that hard work.
$40. 8. Nine.
Even in the best of 25, three sessions, there's always
16
little turning points, and that could prove to be one there, because he would have certainly gone on to take the frame and level the scores.
Seven.
It's not a 25. Straightforward run to the winning line. A couple of reds, awkward.
Yeah, still a little bit of hope for Luca in this frame. The two reds closest to the cushions. On the wrong cushions,
32.
As far as the left hand is concerned. So you may see Mark Williams try and bring them into play.
33.
Although, even so, he's such a tall man, he's not bad with the rest. Hasn't missed a shot with the rest in the championship yet, so. Be interesting to see how he goes about this. He decides to move the reds
39.
Or play in behind them.
40.
Now this is where the safety side of the game is so important, to get
46.
To those two difficult reds. Has he got the angle
46.
On the pink to move this red? As Joe said, being a left-hander, he'd rather bring it into play. And he's certainly done that. It's a tricky little red into the middle, but if he can roll this in...
53.
As we show you the cannon again, if he can roll this in and get on the yellow in such a way, he can move the other red from the yellow, but this is quite an acute angle. 53.
Well, the double is on, and we saw him play a couple in the first session, but be very surprised if he tries to double this. He can get a good safety shot in here. Yeah, wise decision. Chance to take the initiative in this little safety bout. Looking at the table, not guaranteed, of course, but you would expect the next chance to be a telling one. Well, Mark Williams coming round to have a look at this red, so it tells us he can get to the extreme edge, which should make the safety pretty straightforward, but that's pretty tight.
A little tap on the table from Luca there in appreciation, because he had to swerve that slightly to create the angle. all requiring a little thin snicks here so that you don't bring the red into play. And he's brought the red into play. Thought he would play a similar shot and get a really thin contact. This is not easy by any means, but we know what Mark Williams can pot. Another gem of a long pot. Perfect angle on this red, but once again, far from easy along the cushion.
Yeah, guaranteed snooker in behind the black. If he doesn't fancy the red. Decision time. What you must do here, though, is 100% make your mind up. Be fully committed to whichever shot you choose to play. There is real no right or wrong decision here. But you have to be comfortable that you're playing the right shot. Looks like he's taking it on. Yeah, I didn't want to say beforehand in case I give him the curse, but for me, he's one of the best players in the game. Balls near cushions. The long red to start. That red there, he doesn't very rarely miss them. He plays them at such a nice pace. Doesn't overhit them. Gives the pocket every chance.
16.
And that should be a frame winner. Just this yellow. Snooker's required. Yeah, so a good start for Mark Williams this morning. Looks like he's won the first two. Re-established that two-frame lead.
Yeah, this is a sort of a mini body blow to Luca Brasseil because he was odds on to take the frame and all of a sudden missed a straightforward 25. Red, hampered slightly with another red, but that's gone.
This time, but
30 and the frame.
Mark Williams over two frame lead. Luca first in with 45. Wasn't enough. Mark Williams takes the frame. Now leads 6-4.
Thank you.
Thank you. The 11th frame. Luca Brissell to break.
Well, this second session starting exactly where the opening session started, with Mark Williams taking the first two frames. He went full-blooded for that. I thought he was just going to drop it in and maybe leave a difficult black. He tried to force it through to get on the blue and tucked up on the cushion. Boy, that would have been some shot. Oh, he's overcut that. That's. He was actually playing pot that and get round onto the black. And he hit it far too thin. So another chance here, a much easier one than the previous one that Luca attempted. And there's still a couple of reds available. The one at the back looks as if it goes into the right corner. It's got the perfect angle on the blue if he wants to go straight into the pink, though. Oh, when he hit that pink full on. He deserves to be an all sorts athlete the way he played that. And he is. You won't see a better split than this. Watch the cue ball. It just stops there in the middle of the table.
Yeah, perfect example of how to hit the bunch off the blue. Similar shot in the last frame, but didn't quite catch the pink four and landed awkward. You can see there, when you catch it perfectly, all the balls open up, black still in play. So Luca, important now that he converts this chance. Doesn't want to miss anything from here on in, because Mark Williams, you assume, we're talking about the benefits. So this is all about concentration now for Luca. Give every single shot 100%. 40. He's got such a lovely, relaxed walk and cue action. To do too much 22. Here with the cue ball, but he would like to move that red away close to the black at some point in the near future. Just always easier when the black goes in both pockets. Yes, that was a nice little deft touch just to push that red on. And no real 22. Obstacles at all now.
Yeah, he's a total natural player, is Luca Brissell. I love watching this player. I know he does miss the odd easy pots. It's difficult 37. To teach someone. You know, you don't want to stop his natural flow.
38.
And when he stops missing the odd easy pot, he's some force.
Forty-five. 46.
Yeah, there's a lot of similarities in Luca's game to Mark Williams. Just seems to have the ability to shrug off bent errors like in the last frame and just come straight back next time.
53.
Mark Williams very similar. Doesn't dwell on mistakes and bad shots.
54.
This is the perfect response. A few shots away now from securing his first frame this morning. He's took these well. It was all created, of course, by that wonderful split 61. Off the blue. Yeah, I like to see this. It's not absolutely straightforward, so he's just giving it plenty of thought in his own mind. Being very clear exactly what you're doing. Just two or three shots away now from securing this frame.
62.
When he went 2-0 down at the start of this match, his response was a century break. He lost the two opening frames, and this is his response here.
Frame 74.
Already safe, and now he can concentrate on making a century.
85, 82, 83, 90.
Just a little bit of noise coming from the other table in between frames. But when you're playing like this, I was going to say it doesn't bother you, but it's
98.
Upset his positional shot, so he needs a terrific recovery.
99.
I mean, that is a wonderful shot. And this is a wonderful century break.
106.
Does this go up past the green? Of course it does.
107.
130. And hope to find one of the six pockets.
Oh.
Tried to cut the yellow into the right Parker corner, believe it or not. And lost the two opening frames and bounced back with a century break. And he closes the deficit to just one frame, 6-5 to Mark Williams.
Thank you, frame 12. Mark Williams to bring.
Mark Williams. gets the final frame of this mini session underway, and I think after that break off is exactly why he played a different kind of shot on his first attempt. Obviously not comfortable getting that cue ball round. And he left a pretty gettable red there for Luca. Luca will be disappointed with that. That was a chance.
That was an attacking double that he took on there. But I think he's covered everything into the right corner there. But he definitely played a double and played to get onto a ball color.
One.
Let's have another look at that one. Wow. Let's have a look here. That's a beauty. I'll have to call him Luca Brazil.
Five. Six.
Played down on this red. There was easier reds available. But this one gets him access to the black. Yeah, that was tough. Surprised.
Luca Brazil, 11.
He went about it that way. Maybe didn't feel he could safely land on one of the open reds, but there was, like I say, there was easier reds than that to get on.
Now that was tough, and he's left the red that he missed. He was leaving the one next to the blue, but that was a very tough angle there to judge.
Yeah, both players really attacking this morning. Neither
one
player seems to want to play any kind of containing safety shot. That was a real tough red to middle there for Mark Williams. But nothing wrong with that. If you feel good, positive, you want to push on, get the frames won. So can't criticise the shot selection. Just sometimes when they don't go in, you just give the table back to your opponent.
Five.
Shake of the head there for Luca. It looks like these reds pot into the left corner, but clearly not, so playing the thinner. There's a nice pot.
Six.
So you can see the red at the bottom of the pack does go, but it's not easy to land on that. Not much room there between them reds. So only really one open red here for Luca to get on, and then he's going to have to play some kind of cannon, you feel.
Eight. Nine.
Well, we've seen the shot he played in the previous frame when he potted the blue and hit the pink full ball. Are we going to get a repeat of that? hit it half ball. And as soon as you catch the pink half ball, every chance of going in off to either corner.
14.
Didn't quite get the contact this time. But when you pop 15. Like this, he really is a shot maker, Luca Brasseur. Some of the pots that he pulls out, it's quite extraordinary.
Yes,
so he's again very quickly got all the reds in open play, more than enough there to win the frame at this visit now. Referee Jan Verhaas just checking the pink spot. It's not going to make too much difference. Right, pot's end stop on its spot anyway, so
20.
No problem there for Luca. So same as the last frame. Just a case now of holding your concentration, seeing this one through. Good shot, so
32.
Once he removes both of these reds, that opens up the path for the reds below the pink into the right corner. So this is excellent stuff from Luca Brasseur. Great response. He's looking very sharp.
40. 41.
Just let the white go a little further than he intended. That's what stopped him slightly in his tracks. He wants to make sure he gets the right contact here. And it's not bad. He's got the one to the left middle pocket.
48.
Any sort of cannon was always going to leave a pot on.
49.
The frame safe, so concentrate on a possible century.
Yes,
he's just wonderful to watch, this player.
63. 64.
Can't separate these players at the moment. They're so evenly matched.
67. 68.
The record number of century breaks made at the Crucible was last year, actually. 109 centuries. We're on 43 already. That record 75. Might go this year.
80, 82, 85. 84.
Just the pink then. Back to back set. One last from Luca Brasel. What a performance. Oh, that's a shame. Back to back centuries sees Luca Brasel restore parity. Fantastic mini session of snooker. Can't split them. Six apiece.
Thank you. Frame 13. Luca Brasel to break.
Thank you, Seema. And as you join us, another terrific pot from Mark. And he's on the brown. I mean, that looked to be a pretty good break-off shot. But this is the type of pot that the players practice hour and end these days.
Mark Williams.
We're so used to seeing him. Mark missed very little, but he had to get a little bit of pace on that to get onto the red, so he's handed the early initiative here. Can Luca continue where he left off?
One. Eight. Nine. 15.
Important to leave an angle this time.
16.
That looks pretty good with the pack like this. Luca, you would imagine, would stun up into the reds if he screws off them. It could end up back on this back cushion. So yeah, he did screw off them, and that's what's happened. Needed to stun, push through the pack there, leave 20. The cue ball somewhere near the middle of the table. This red go to right middle. It's tough. Awkward cue in from the side cushion. It's just going to catch the near jaw, is it? Yeah.
Look at Brasel, 23.
He played it in a clever way. He would have been on the brown had it gone in. Wasn't leaving much for Mark, so it was a value shot. Be disappointed, though. You'd have expected to have got on a red there when playing into the pack. Is Mark thinking about taking a double one here, or can he clip this into the right middle? Dangerous shot, if that's what he chooses.
He was almost down and taking the double on. Is he still going to take it? Not easy to judge that double, but cleverly played. He wasn't going to leave anything. Just get the white tight on the cushion behind the black. You can't get in behind the black, I don't think, but anywhere a little thin one and tight on the cushion would leave Mark with a slight problem. I don't think you can see enough of this red to take it on up past the green. the branch in the way. Otherwise, you can see there, it's not guaranteed that. Much better choice there. Just a little bit of a stalemate here, just simply because of the reds that are up past the blue and pink. But as long as you keep getting the white tight, or almost tight in this cushion, you've got the slight advantage. Oh, that was well played. That wasn't easy. You can see Luca just tapping the cushion with his cue there to raise the butt of the cue in the air and judge that screw back and leave it tight was excellent. Now the advantage is with the Welshman. Nothing for Luca to just roll up to, which might force him into taking that very difficult pot into the middle pocket. What a shot he's taking on here. That is wonderful. No easy escape. You won't see many better pots than that. And what a chance he's given himself. That was some shot, that, Joe.
Yeah, it's almost like Mark Williams' safety shot was too good. Left Luca no option but to take that red on, but didn't make it any easier, of course. Not a lot Mark Williams can do about that. Incredible pot. And now look at these reds. All just dotted in the middle of the table. Around the blue. So a great chance for Luca to hit the front for the second time in this match. He led at 4-3. But for the most part, he's been trailing. He's building up a bit of a head of steam here. Finished off back-to-back centuries, and he's in again.
13.
There's the story of the match there, just along the bottom of your screens. It's amazing sometimes the amount of cue that he has between his bridge hand and the cue ball. That's quite close for Luca. Sometimes there's even double that, but it's just natural. It's the way he plays. Sean Murphy was saying that Luke is just as good left-handed, but you very rarely see him do that. That was a 13. Situation there. You would have thought he would have just switched hands, but he's obviously very comfortable with the rest.
36. Again, he's just making it look 36. Ridiculously easy. And he gets in amongst the balls. He's not hanging about. 18 seconds a shot. Hardly any thinking time needed. It's all just very easy for Luke at the moment. And it's easy on the eye for us. It's fantastic to watch.
44.
Yeah, I think I mentioned yesterday about how Ronnie O'Sullivan can take his practice game straight out into the match arena. But this is a player that seems to be able to do it as well, Joe. Okay, misses the odd easy one here and there, but he just sort of plays out there with so much freedom.
Yeah.
52.
Player myself, you sort of a bit of jealousy, really. Just doesn't look like there's any pressure on him whatsoever. Obviously there is, but he just handles it so well. He just plays with such a carefree attitude, clear mind. He accepts the fact that he's going to play the odd bad shot, but it doesn't let it affect him. And that's half the battle out there, playing with freedom, clear mind.
59. 60.
I wonder would he be thinking if he takes the blue, he'd have to get on the black off the last red to make a century break. He'd be well aware of that, I'm sure. Oh, that spoiled it slightly. Cannon in the yellow. No, he's not snookered.
65. 66.
And if it bounces, he's on the black, and he can drop on the yellow. Well, what a shame. It was almost three centuries 66. In a row if that black had dropped. But just the one chance needed, and that was a super.
Quietly, please. Thank you. Frame 14, Mark Williams to break. Mark Williams.
Finished perfect on the blue. I mean, that was a result going all the way around the table to finish there. It might be okay if he's not stuck on that red, he can pop the one to the right. But is
six.
He may be snookered, so he's unlucky. No, he can get through to it, he's just checking the black.
7.
Didn't like the black because of that red next to it. It's awkward. And it's not a good bunch now to go into from the blue. It's got that loose red slightly in the way. And that's finished. Nowhere, I think.
12.
He couldn't really just crash into the reds there, the way they were sitting. Played it well enough, but didn't get a favourable cannon. He might be able to get to the potting angle here. And he could. And what a great shot that is. Okay, he's come up a little bit short, but this was some shot. Didn't look as if he could see the potting angle of that one. Now, the one thing, there's a red over the pocket, but the red near the pink, if he potted the blue, he could put that in off the other red. That's what he's thinking about now. I mean, he can cut the one in that's near the pocket, but it's what we call a big pocket for the other red. That's the big pocket I mentioned, but as I say, he could even roll the blue in and cut the one in that's near the pocket. So he's got a couple of choices here. Yeah, the big pocket's his choice. He might even go straight into the pocket. Like that.
19. This time, right at the top of the bunch.
20.
Use the bunch to screw off and open a few more reds. Just got to be careful. Enough's always a possibility. Should be okay. Yeah, he's just took his eye off the pot, trying to control that cannon.
Mark Williams, 24.
See it all the time. Cue balls run into other reds. It just takes you away from the potting angle sometimes. So a lot of these mistakes from Mark are down to the pressure being applied by Luca. Mark knows he can't afford to let him in. That just makes every shot more difficult.
One.
Again, another nice pot. Great control. Perfectly played. So to turn this into a real good chance, he's got to move the reds away from left and right corner to open up the path for the black. And that was nicely done. Intentional. Doesn't want to be straight on this red though.
Six.
We know he's got bags of cue power and this will test him. Yeah, not a lot there, is there? Got the other red into the right corner, as you can see, but he'll be bridging over this red. So plenty of cue power. He's a shot maker. He's going to need one here. Yeah,
seven.
Just tried to just come past the black, and there wasn't a lot of room there. It was a good effort.
Thank you. Blue ball.
Very well judged. Well, we've had lots of big breaks in this session. We won't be seeing one in this frame. Look at the blue, look at the pink, look at the black. In the last three frames, two century breaks and a frame winning 66 from Luca. But this would be a slightly longer frame because of the situation of the high valued colours.
Friendly little use of the knuckles there for Luca. If he'd gone in off, it was a decent opening red for Mark Williams, but where the cue ball is now, nothing he can really do here. Takes the red on, he's running into other balls, so bit of luck there for Luca. Red full enough, so I think this red's available. You can screw down the table. You would expect him to play positive, land on brown or yellow. Yep, nice pot. One. Just makes them missable pots look so easy. That wasn't easy at all, that pot, but just got down and knocked it in like it was over the pocket.
He's just having a little look around the black spot area. If he can get on the red that's just above the black, not the one next to it, in such a way he could pot that and free the black. And he'll have worked that out. And I'll tell you what, this is not far off being, well, a bit further across the table, and he would have been perfect to take that red and just cannon the one away from the black. Might still be able to do it. But closer to the red would have made it quite easy. Four. Played it very nicely, though.
Again, very quickly.
11.
Opening up the table, making it far more presentable for a
12.
Frame-winning contribution. Just plays all positive shots all the time, Luca. That's why when he's in good form like today, good things happen.
But he's got the one just above the cue ball. But yeah, I thought this was going to be a longish frame with the blue, pink and black were out of commission, but he's got the black in play. And if he had have come up another couple of inches there and was able to pop that red to the right of the black, the frame winning chance was there. It still might be after the next shot.
15.
The one above the little bunch of four is available. It's the one he's played on. He's making the game of snooker look very easy at the moment.
18.
This is very good stuff. I'm not sure any of them triangle of reds are available, but
26
shouldn't be a problem at all here. Any sort of cannon, as long as he doesn't hit that first red full in the face, just glance off it, the left or the right. You'd expect him to be nicely on a red. Yeah, that's okay. Just depends on the angle. I thought he might have hit that a little bit harder. If he's dead straight, he can come back for the black, but I think he might just be just the wrong side of straight here from Luca's perspective. Yeah, he was, but
34. Again,
nicely potted into the middle pocket. So I think he can just about straight enough on this yellow. He needs to be down the left-hand side of the table here, so may need to put a little bit of left-hand side when potting this with a rest, so not straightforward. Oh, didn't like the idea of playing with side. Decided to stun round and
Brussel, 34.
Accidentally hit the green Mark and gone in off. So that's a bit of a reprieve for Mark Williams. Wasn't looking like he was going to get back to the table in this frame.
Oh, that's a nice little series of flicks he's had there. That was a tough red that Mark decided to take on there. And once he missed it, every chance he could have stuck the red up, but he's okay, you would think. That was much too thick with the safety there. This is an easier chance than the previous one that Mark took on.
Yeah, but that cue has just come to rest in an awkward spot for Mark Williams. Bridging over the yellow. May it be enough to stop him from attempting this red. Good pot under the circumstances. Awkward queuing there. Needs this cue ball to run. Again, things just landing a little bit awkward at the moment for Mark Williams. Expected to be nice on any one of them colours there.
think he can get through to the potting angle on the green, but he's decided against it, and this is quite a good choice.
Mark Williams won.
He'd love to have been able to have taken the green and got on the last red, but this is a good alternate.
Foul. And a miss. Mark Williams, four.
Having a big smile to each other. He nearly fluked it in the corner and the middle pocket. But he had to create the angle. That's why he hit it so hard. It wasn't a natural angle to escape from that. Bit unlucky to leave it there.
Oh.
Amazing, but that red needs to pull up. Yeah, he's okay, but you see that last shot, it shows you what can happen into these middle pockets. He was almost straight and playing it with pace, just misjudged it, and the white can always follow it in.
It's been a while since we had a frame like this in this match. A lot of the frames have been pretty one-sided. The songs have been played at a fair old pace this match. Average frame time before this one was less than 15 minutes. But there's still plenty of snooker left in this one. Blue, pink and black side cushion. That's in Luca's advantage at the moment. It's only an 8-point lead, but could be very telling if he can pop this red. He won't need blue, pink or black. And how about this shot? If this white ball keeps rolling. Oh, has it just got there? I think it has. It's only a slight swerve, as you can see, but not always easy to control where the red's going to finish. Played it gently and too gently. This is a chance.
Mark knows that this white has finished tight in the cushion, which makes it a little awkward for Luca. A couple of inches off the cushion, this would have been a straightforward run to the winning line in this frame. As Joe mentioned, he doesn't need the difficult blue. The yellow passes the green, he's okay, but I doubt whether it does. But it was a natural angle. He didn't really want to have to cannon the blue out. Now, this must be pretty tight, this. And that little shake of the head tells you that it is. Well, especially if he's looking at it from the other end as well. Maybe just half a pocket to go at.
Luca Brissell, three.
So just the fact that the white finished tight on the cushion when he had to take the yellow on caused the problem. Now, expect him to hit the yellow. Could he pot it? Well, he's had a good result there. And all he could do was just hit that at pace and hope to get it safe. And he couldn't have got it any safer. Just wondering if he can see enough to just flick the cushion and maybe get snooker behind the pink. No, it's just gone. If the yellow is a fraction away from the pink, he could have hit cushion first and dropped him in behind the pink. I don't think he can do it here. He's not going to reach, is he?
Oh, miss. Mark Williams, yeah.
Having it put back, but... The shot that I mentioned is not on just because the yellow is a bit too close to the pink.
Yeah, it was a really clever safety shot from Mark. You know, Mark needs the pink.
How much?
And putting the yellow that close to it. Luke Ross doesn't want to bring the pink into play, but you would imagine on Mark's next visit to the table, he's going to have the opportunity to get the pink out. Maybe not. He's done quite well there, Luca. He's going to have a similar sort of problem on his next visit to the table.
Pretty good. Oh, where's the yellow going to finish? He's got away with it, has he? He certainly has. There was no easy safety shot, so he had to have a go with that difficult yellow there. Slight advantage here because of that pink being safe. Luca needs the yellow, green, brown and the blue. Mark would need the difficult pink. And that's very well played. And he's faced with the job of trying to knock the yellow safe again. You never know where they're going to go. Settle for that. Well, that was a brave shot to take on there. He's got second best, I think.
Well, they say fortune favours the brave. It did on that occasion. Yeah, this isn't easy. I don't think the one cushion on the side cushion is available. I think the pink slightly in the way. So opting to play the swerve. Yeah, it was a good shot. That's pretty much exactly how he intended that to play out. So gradually, all the balls getting into play. So big safety battle on here. So we're approaching longest frame of the match so far. Almost there. It's only the second frame in this match that's gone over 20 minutes. Just shows how easy on the eye it's been, free flowing, big breaks flying in, but these frames count just the same.
Yeah, Mark Williams is slightly ahead in the safety success department, but Luca's certainly matching him here. Now you can see 84% to Luca's 76%. Clever safety shots from both players. Sure, if the yellow passes the black, it's might just go, but with the distance between cue ball and object ball, it's a tough pot. Very well played. I was just about to say, if he misses the brown, he's going to drop in behind the green.
Williams
too. I'm trying to bring that pink into play, which would be to Mark's advantage, but it's still fairly safe. This will be some shot. That was a chance to clinch the frame there if the green goes in.
Find himself behind the pink next time he comes to the table. that was the intention, but he'd be disappointed with that. Very disappointed, Mark Williams. That was a chance to get Luca there. So another chance at this green, and you would imagine if it goes in, he'll have no problem getting brown and blue to secure the frame. Nice, just gently rolled it in. What a fantastic shot. What a way to play that shot, Dennis.
There's very few players in the game would have just dropped that in. They would have played it with a bit of pace. I mean, that was superb. Well, we've seen him take doubles on where he's just dropped them in, Joe, and that green was that was some shot, really, to give him the frame.
So one snooker required. It's not going to be easy for Mark Williams to get the snooker with that plaque near the jaws of the pocket. He'll have to have a go. If the black was right over the pocket, Mark Williams would probably try and get the pink very close to it, but that's not really an option. So Mark Williams is going to need all his years of experience to try and work something here.
Yeah, this pink. Luke will just roll this pink into the corner pocket, in or over, as we call it. But not as close to the pocket as he would have liked. I mean, there's a distinct, but a very rare opportunity to get in behind that black, but how is he going to get himself in a situation where there's the possibility of that happening? And if he was to get in behind the black, it would be an almost impossible snooker to hit. There's a way of getting the white round the table here if he hits the cushion first, but he's not looking at that, but it was a chance to swing the white around the angles. He's just going this way, and I'll tell you what, this is a pretty good effort. Very good effort indeed. Oh, that's unlucky. Brilliant effort. Greatest players that's ever played the game. Let's see you get a snooker from here. I just couldn't keep the pink out. So Luca Bissell, as both players leave the arena, has extended his lead. He's now 8-6 in front. As I say, both players have left the arena, so you can have a little look at the story of this match. This fascinating match, it has to be said. There's all the details, and we'll be back with a commentary when they come back.
Thank you. Frame 15. Luca Brasel to break.
Luca Brasel gets us underway, and he's on a four-frame winning streak at the moment. Important now for Mark Williams to put a stop to this little bit of momentum. That'll help. It's just, things are just starting to fall awkward. Mark, he's putting some good balls and just not landing nicely. So again, he can just drop one of these yellow or brown in and leave himself mid-distance red, or take on the trickier black, which gives him better position. But either way, it's not straightforward. Yeah, good pot. I think the cue ball's just held up enough. Needs another one now.
Five. Six.
That's a wonderful shot. Not so much the pot, which was excellent, but to get the cue ball the correct side of the blue there was superb. And being a left-hander, he can get the black back on its spot, but then the reds are all 11. Safe, so he needs a good angle on the black if he plays for it to try and bring some of the reds into play. I think it'll be slightly easier maybe if he had the white near the cushion just to stun over into the reds. If he leaves the white where he was looking, it's a much more difficult pot. Decided to leave the black for the time being.
Mark Williams, 12.
Well, he looked at the black from a couple of angles and then decided, I'll go up for the blue and try and open the game up. But he'd gone a bit too far on the blue there, Joe, didn't he?
Yeah, he wasn't perfect on it, but I still expected him to knock it in. Oh, but is that
one
of the very few? I don't like using the word careless, but I don't know what other word to use. It's a pretty straightforward positional shot there for Luca to get up the table. So he's been positive today.
Yellow.
Is he going to take this yellow on? He is. It doesn't matter where they are. Just keeps knocking them in. Could
Three.
Have easily understood him playing safe there. 8-6 up, but he doesn't look like he wants to. He's up here, he sees the opportunity to maybe push on and get a nice lead going into the final session.
And look at this shot, this will free the pink.
Four.
Yeah, you can see enough of the black that Mark thought about leaving from this sort of angle. That's opened the pink and the red that were next to it. He hasn't looked at the pink yet. You know, the pink may go up into the corner pocket. He's just fully focused on cutting the black in. Nicely played. delicate little cut back there.
Be lovely.
And he's got them exactly where he wants them again here. So how costly 12. Is that blue going to be, the one that Mark missed into the right middle pocket when probably was concentrating more on the cannon?
A chance there for any sort 19. Of cannon on the three reds. It was going to be nicely on a red to right corner, but it hasn't worked out. So another tricky little shot facing him here. Just crept in. Maybe they catch that near jaw, they don't fall in, but at that pace, gravity takes over. And he's just looking so impressive. All the big shots he's had to knock in, he just deals with them.
26.
He's kept that nice fluent pace up to date.
27.
Now look at the table. And of course, winning this frame guarantees him a lead going into the final session this evening when they come back to finish this match off.
34. Forty-three.
And once again, very fluent.
57.
When he's in the balls.
58.
One more frame after this.
65.
Mark Williams could do with it because this player is
66.
Reaching top form at just the right time.
72.
'If he could get himself onto the black in such a way, he'd be able to bring the difficult last red into play and give himself a chance of another century break. And this is about perfect.
73.
If it drops, yeah, that looks good to me.
72.
Yeah, it was difficult to just flick it over the middle pocket.
80.
Well, believe it or not, he's only a couple of reds, but it doesn't matter. Another fantastic contribution, this time of 80. He's Luca continuing winning streak. It's five in a row now. Leads 9 frames to 6.
Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Final frame of the session. Mark Williams.
Mark gets the final frame of this second session underway, and he could do with winning it. First to 13 takes the match. Okay, even at 10-6, he's still in there, but he wants to stop the rot, so to speak. He lost five frames in a row against his opponent, who's really buzzing at the moment. And normally he knocks those in, but that shows you even someone like Mark Williams, who suffers the pressure out there, never shows it. He's so laid back. He He's always been like that. He could walk out of an arena. He could have won six frames in a row or lost six frames in a row, and you can't tell the difference.
That's what makes these long matches fascinating.
Six.
It's very disconcerting for Mark Williams. He's sitting in his chair and he just sees Luca strolling around the table, knocking everything in. So when that chance does come, there's extra pressure attached because he knows he's more than likely going to be punished heavily. So just
14.
Make sure this red gives himself a nice angle.
15.
That's okay. We saw a shot like this earlier on and Luca played it with screw as opposed to stun and he lost the cue ball. This time, stunned it. And what's the result? Perfect. That's the difference when you stun into the reds like that 22. As opposed to screw off them. And he's in again. It just seems within a few shots, he has the table at his mercy. So attacking and positive in his shot selection. Great to see.
Twenty-nine.
Yeah, he looked a little disappointed as he walked around the table.
36.
Shouldn't have been anywhere near the cushion there.
But
once again, made that look as if it was over the pocket. The only thing is when you run slightly out of position, it snowballs for a couple of shots. Last red that's available.
43. 44.
The one to the left of the pack he might have to play for because he's straight. Yep, he had no angle there with the black, so this one was the only one available.
51. Brussel, 51.
A very rare miss from Luca Brussel, but no harm done. The Reds run safe. Nice 51-point lead. Final frame of the session. But could that miss prove costly? Just every part of his game just seems in fine order. You would have expected Mark Williams to have the edge in the safety department. But Lucas matched him all the way, and he's outscored him in this session considerably.
Clever shot. The only red he could leave was the one he had a go at. Now that is very careless from Aloka there. That white should have been on the ball cushion. And this red shouldn't have been available. But still, there's a bit of a tester for Mark Williams. But it's a shot that he shouldn't have had a go at, really. Oh, a bit unlucky. Bit unlucky.
Yellow ball. Mark Williams.
And that's not the best shot that Mark's ever played. He was trying to get the white tight on the cushion, and he's left a possible pot for Luca.
Yeah, it's almost as if Luca has realised the enormity of this frame. Last couple of shots not been hit with that beautiful stroke. He knows a 10-6 lead. Okay, it's not over, but that's a nice lead going into the final session. It just seems to have tightened up a little bit. And how about this?
What a safety shot from Mark Williams.
He didn't waste long. He could have done with just... Well, he's played it so well. I mean, he got down straight away. He was always going to take this shot, but he's left a possible pot along the cushion. But he got down immediately and seen the angle to go twice across the table. This is a delicate one, but we know how good he is at floating this type of shot in. It's not easy. No. Is it there? It is. Oh, wonderful. Thought he was going to catch the right-hand jaw, but safely in. Well, what a frame this would be to pinch.
Eight.
Nine. 16. That's right. That goes down. Clears the
17.
Path for the next red on above the black. That will then release the other two, so this very quickly unravelling. Luke Robbie, a little bit concerned.
24.
A couple of chances to put this frame away. Big moment 24. In this match. Still a long way to go, but this could be one of them frames we look back on as a turning point.
Yeah, and just looking at the yellow, I think it's probably in a better position with the green safe. Okay, that's maybe 6-7 shots away, but
32.
He'll concentrate on these three reds, but he'll have that yellow at the back of his mind. Just a couple of frames that got a little awkward. 36-minute frame and a 28-minute frame, but the rest has been fast and furious.
39. 40.
He's going to be faced with the choice when he gets to the yellow, as to drop in behind the green or leave 46. An angle on the yellow to just cannon the green into a more favourable position. So 47. All about the angle he gets on the yellow, that will then make his decision for him. And looking at that angle, he may have to drop in behind it.
54.
Or can he bring the green into play? Not from that angle, so this 56. Is the key shot. Wonderful display 59. From Mark Williams here. As Joe mentioned, Luca had his chances to put the frame mm-hmm. away. We can't give this player half a chance, 66. Especially under pressure. We know how good he is.
68.
But now there's just going to be two the difference, and looking forward to this evening session. It's going to be some match between these two players that are playing so well.
74.
Another fine display from both players. It's not a four-frame gap. Mark Williams reduces his arrears, and he comes back this evening just two behind at 9-7.